Welcome, wrestling fans, to the Wisconsin Valley Wrestling Conference Tournament here in Merrill, Wisconsin. We are kind of behind the schedule here, getting set up due to some problems here at the field house. But Kale Benitz against Ben Dinney against Wausau East is on the mat, a preliminary match. He's been taken down and is being ridden by Dinney. These two did not meet in the dual meet earlier in the year. Dinney was up at 113. Benitz on his back with a double arm bar by Dinney. And got pinned in 48 seconds in his first round matchup. Benitz getting pinned by Dinney of Wausau East. Dinney is a sophomore. We do not have the matchups. They just started, and they're just still printing out bracketing here for us. So we will give you those updates as fast as we can. Joining me in the broadcast area doing color is Mr. Lewie Benitz. I'm Scott Tesch. Keeping us all straight here with the stats is Joyce Benitz. So while we do a quick catch-up here and some bookwork, we're going to take a quick break. We'll be back with more Lincoln High School Red Raider Wrestling on River City's Community Access. Jared Mata, 220 pounds, getting ready to go out against This is Antonio Anaya of Marshfield. Now, that's Antonio Anaya, of Marshfield. Is the first round matchup of Jared Mata at 220 pounds. And we'll give you a quick update here. As, like I said, we got set up really late here due to some problems here at Merrill. None of River City's, but Kale Benitz got pinned by Ben Dinney in 48 seconds at 103 pounds. Matrix just go first round by. No entrant at 113, 126 for the Red Raider. Pat Sprayer first round by. Berg Diebel a by. Max Benitz a bye, Cody Sawyer a bye, Brock Benitz a bye. Dylan Hall will be up here against Nate White shortly. Nathan Fuller first round bye, Jake Tim a bye, and Jack Berwink at heavyweight a bye. So, now that we caught you up on the first round here, Mata in on a single leg on Anaya of Marshfield.
Come on, throw that half. We're watching Jared Mata, and he got a quick pin here.
39 seconds on the fall for Jared Mata. Again, he's wrestling at 220 pounds for the Red Raiders.
Well, as the day goes by here, Scott, we're missing two weights, and then it seems like numbers are just going to be an issue because Wausau West is missing two kids, too, and that's the team to beat here today.
And Merrill down a handful of kids.
Yeah, Merrill had eight kids weighed in as well. But we've got our kids moved up again, kind of because Brock Benitz went down to 60, which was the tougher weight, which means that to fill all the weight classes, Hall went to 70, Fuller to 82, and Tim at 195. So these bonus points become pretty important now. And unfortunately, in a bye, you don't get those. If you win your next round, then you get pinpoints from the bye, but you have to advance. So it's kind of these bonus points early become pretty important for us. So we're waiting to get Dylan Hall here at 170. And we're in kind of an interesting place here where we're on the floor and we're kind of in an area where we can see all the mats, but I guess it's a good spectator area.
Yeah, we're in a spot where we can see the mats kind of tucked in here, again, lots of issues to start with this morning.
Yeah.
And now that we're finally on the air here, we're going to be doing all right here. Again, the Red Raiders are going to get a little more action going on as the tournament goes here. Dylan Hall is going to step on the mat right now, so we'll stay right here. Hall is taking on Nate White out of DC Everest. in his first round matchup. And these two, excuse me, we had that change. Michael Olson of Wausau West will be his first round opponent. And these two, we'll look at the dual meet here. Michael Olson and Dylan Hall wrestled at 160 in the dual meet, and Hall pinned him in 108.
I can't keep up with these programs here. I thought we were going to get white. This is a lot better draw for us. And even though we wrestle up at 70, Dylan probably weighs almost that much. It looks to me like Olson isn't, they're about the same size is what I'm seeing.
Right. To take down Hall off that nice single leg shot. He's got a leg lift here and a tip. And Olson's trying to roll through off his back. Hall's trying to keep him here. But he can't quite do that. Wasn't in tight enough on that ride. Near fall though, 4-0. Dylan Hall leads. A minute 20 left in the first period. And air off the mat.
Yeah, he started out really well. It was a nice takedown. He went right into a Turk and had Olson on his back there for a while, but couldn't keep him there. But again, this is probably a good spot for Dylan. The favorite at this weight would be Joe Roth from Point, and then we've also got Nate White from Everest, who's probably the second seed.
All trying to continue to ride with a minute left, leading 4-0. Olson tried to get to his feet. Hall locked up on him, kind of crab rode him right back to the mat. Now they're out of bounds. A new wrestling mats here, the dark black base color and then a dark blue striping on them. So they're a little hard from an angle to see the circles. Hall with a shot again from the feet. 1 point given the free ride back, and now Hall back in on a single leg. Out the back side, lifts, puts him on his back. He was stuck for an instant. Referee on the wrong side. 2 takedown Hall, he leads 6-1. 25 seconds left in the first period. And we're counting down from 5 seconds here. Hall will ride out Olson of Wausau West and take a 6-1 lead into the second period. Hall's choice he deferred, or excuse me, Olson's choice he deferred. Hall takes a down position to start the second period. Hall puts his feet on the mat in a hurry and gets his hands free, gets the escape. 7-1 now. Hall definitely the quicker of the two here. And they back up towards the center of the mat. Minute 35 left. Still 7-1 Hall. Three mats on the floor here at the Merrill High School. Nice shot in, caught a half. Half got picked off, though.
He's wrestling pretty well here. Dylan hasn't wrestled very much lately. He's got that hand injury and trying to figure out if it's going to be good enough to go at the regional, and that was the test today.
1-11 left, 9-1 Hall, now 9-2. They're going to give him the free ride back to his feet. Hall again with another nice shot. A couple of head taps. Drove in on a single. See if he can complete it. Get a little stretched out here, though. And they work their way off the mat. 57 seconds left. Second period. Hall 9-2 right now. A lot of noise. There's a couple of big heavyweights there on the mat. Nice little head tap and a shot in on a single by Hall. See if he can complete the takedown. Coming up, trying to come out the back side. He's got the takedown, 11-2.
Usually dominating this match, and Olsen gives him a lot of opportunities to throw half Nelson's off of this crossbody ride, but he can't hold him there. It kind of must be pretty flexible.
And Dylan's throwing the half with that taped up hand and trying to use the leverage behind the head with that hand might have some effect on it. Time for a restart. 4 seconds left, 11-2 Hall with a lead, and they're taking a quick look at a little abrasion on the side of the face. End of period number two, 11-2 Hall with a lead. And this is Olsen's choice from Wausau West. He's looked over at the coaches and he said, oh, I guess I'll go down.
We're looking at trying to get some bonus points out of this. Like most matches, if you're winning it pretty convincingly, which he is, now we want to either get the tech fall or ideally the pin.
The pin. You get a half a point team score added on if you win by a major decision. Or is that, no, that's a point if you win by a major. And it's a point and a half.
2 points if you win by a pin.
2 points if you win by a pin, a point and a half by a tech fall.
If I can have your attention, wrestlers on mat number three. Your time frame is just about done, so hopefully you can.
All still on top riding.
We're ready to go.
He's having trouble holding him here. He's throwing him all over the place, but not getting any back points out of it.
Most of the time, you see Hall put somebody to their back from their feet. You don't see him on top trying to turn somebody. So
it's probably time to cut him right about now.
I would think so, and try to get a tech anyway. Seconds left. Warning, stalling, Olsen from West.
We're not getting any improvement here, though. We're just kind of
covering a hip and
riding it, controlling him, and it's time to cut him, guys. And Olsen from Wausau West is just kind of moving around on the bottom, just enough not to get
for the wrestlers
back
and
points.
Parents, if you look at the top of the clock.
Tip and temp.
Now here we go.
Hall's got some near fall coming. Can he get him stuck here? Got 5 seconds.
That's the time of the next.
Looks pretty flat. Two, one. Oh, and the ref couldn't quite get in position. Three near fall. It's 14-2. Major decision to Dylan Hall.
Yeah, if we could have got into that position just a little bit earlier, I think you're probably right. We look like we're a couple seconds away from a fall.
Yeah, if we needed another 5 seconds, that would have been pretty good.
Yeah.
But Hall comes out with a major decision, 14-2. The next Red Raider to wrestle will be Matrix Jisco on mat one. He had a first-round bye. He'll take on Wausau West Frank Lohr at 120 pounds. We'll bring you more Lincoln High School Red Raider Wrestling from the Valley Conference Wrestling Tournament on River City's Community Access. And now we're up at 120-pounders, Matrix Jisco against Chen Chemeng from Lohr from Wausau West.
That's kind of a tough draw this early in the tournament. Lohr's been around a little bit. That's a nice takedown.
These two did not wrestle in a dual meet earlier.
You know what? This could be his brother, I guess.
Oh, nice little head tug and then a doubling
shot.
Well,
and we've been waiting for a long time for Matrix to get on the offense. You know, he hasn't protected his legs very well. And
fell behind early.
What I've told him, and I'm sure the coaches have, we got to get on offense. Boy, almost took him to his back.
Yeah, almost
there.
Launched him. He's going on a takedown offensive here. Leads 6-3 right now, looking to get it to 8-3.
Well, he's going into a little tilt here. Yeah, this can't be the Laura from last year, can it?
No, this is Chemeng. It's not Frank. Three near fall, so it's already 11-3. Again, you don't want to run a score with a chance to get a pin here. You don't want, you want to leave yourself a little leeway here.
Yeah, you're right. But I think this is pretty much a bygone
35
conclusion.
35 seconds
there.
Left. Don't need that. 1:28 on a fall time. Matrix just go over Chemeng Lohr and Wausau West. Good to see Matrix hitting some offense, moving his feet.
Absolutely, yeah. That's been without having his mother get after me. He flatlines quite a bit. That's my terminology for somebody that just don't spike or peak or get that adrenaline rush or whatever you need. And we've seen him down the last couple of years later in the season kind of get a little cautious late in the match and ended up losing. You don't have the real quick feet, and so then you stay on offense, so you don't have to counter.
Right.
But anyway, he's off to a good start here.
Yep, winning 1:28 on the pin time. Now we're waiting for the time to run up here between matches, and Patrick Spray should take on, we got the last name, Heath from Wausau East. We do not have a first name. We're still trying to figure that out, so we'll get that to you as soon as we can. We'll take a quick break. We'll be back with more Red Raider Wrestling. Patrick Spray at 132 pounds against Dylan Heath out of Wausau East. Take a look. He's not in the lineup when they had the dual meet earlier in the year with the Red Raiders, so fresh matchup for Spray.
Spray's the top seed here at 132.
In the conference, ranked number 3 in the state. Spray into a hard single. Trying to catch an arm and stack him up here for near fall. He's got 2 in the lead.
There will be a break after the second
round. Now they cut him loose, 2-1.
There will be a lunch break after the second round.
Spray with a nice elbow-controlled single-leg shot. Another takedown, they're going to cut him loose. Spray's got a nice flow to his match. It's from one thing to the next to the next to the next.
He's put in a lot of time. He's a real smart kid. He's got pretty good skills. He's just a great kid. But he's got good quickness too. And he's got some strength. You know, the last couple of years he's always been overpowered quite a bit. I think the weight room has helped him a little.
1 minute left, 6-2 Spray, and he will try to ride. Out over the point of the shoulder, trying to dig out that right side wrist. He's got it across the back. Couple options here. Goes for a tip. Got a couple laying here. 25 seconds left, 3 near fall. It's now 9-2 Spray. This is a half here. Trying to get it in deeper. Half comes out.
Well, this is going to be over. He's in here pretty tight, and it's kind of a matter of time here, I think.
Pin and 150 for Patrick Spray. Picking up an extra couple of pin points for the Red Raiders team totals. Spray with a first round bye. And waiting to come out right behind him is Berg Diebel, who also had a first round bye. He's wrestling at 138. And he will take on Wausau East Ryan Daniel.
Our draws are pretty good here this early.
Patrick Spray in the dual meet wrestled Ryan Daniel, a freshman, pinned him in 117 earlier in the year. And Debo in on a takedown right off the get-go. Got a barbed wire.
A lot of young kids in this tournament. And we're kind of the exception here. We have a lot of seniors, which doesn't bode real well for next year. But.
Four-one right now with the free ride back to the feet. Diebel with a lead. Daniel with a bad shot in. Diebel caught him in a front chin lock. Shot and a reshot, neither one completed, 1:15 left. Evil puts him in a front headlock now. Back trip, takes him over. Got a takedown, can you keep him here for near fall?
We used to call that the Gomez because there was a kid from Glenbard North that did that to us a few times. Reached through.
Off that front headlock, reach cross body, trip that knee on the other side.
Kind of a little background on this tournament, or not background, but the Raiders went 6-0 in the Valley, so we're undefeated in the conference. And then to win a championship in the Valley, you have to, it's a combination of the dual meets and the tournament. So it's a combination of points, and we got the inside. We'd have to finish out of the top two, not to at least tie for this thing.
And so, you'd have to have, Wausau West?
Wausau West.
Finish in first place in this tournament.
Yeah, yeah. So years ago, we tried to figure out a fair way to determine a conference championship, and there's a couple of ways of looking at it. If you just go on the tournament, which we did way back a long time ago, that's a one day, and it just didn't seem fair to us to put all the weight of a whole season on one day. So then for a few years, we went just with the dual meets, and it was in those days where we won maybe 20 in a row, I don't know. But and that was fine, and then we get ganged up on in the votes in the conference coaches meeting, and we decided then to come up with a plan where it was both. So that's where we're at now. So it seems like the fairest way.
Yeah, you get two points in your total for every dual meet win.
Yep.
And then points in reverse order for the way you finish in this tournament.
Absolutely.
And you add the two totals together, and that's where you finish in the conference. Berg with a reversal, ooh, half and a bar, and that's it.
That was a nice combination he put together there. And Berg Diebel, we're going to have to count on down the road here a little bit. So we're picking up some pin points here, and I think that's the plan.
236 on the pin time for Berg Diebel at 138 pounds. Max Benitz, they're waiting on time, and he will take on Brody Gehrke out of Merrill. At 152, Cody Sawyer will get a second-round match against Stevens Point David Loomis. Brock Benitz with two buys in a row at 160. At 170, Dylan Hall will take on Nate White of DC Everest. Nathan Fuller, after his first round buy, will get Connor Peterson out of Marshfield. Jake Tim has two buys in a row. Jared Mata, who wrestled Antonio Anaya Marshall and pinned him in 39 seconds, will get Brady Lentz out of Wausau West. And then Jack Verwink, after his first round buy, gets Chris Gehrink out of DC Everest. So we'll take a quick break. We'll be back with more of the Valley Conference Wrestling Tournament. And we're back now with Cody Sawyer at 152 pounds against David Lummox of Stevens Point. And Max Benitz will be heading out at 145 against Brody Gehrke out of Merrill. Ankle pick.
We could pin him right out of here.
He could get this. This could be really nice here if he can get him stacked on his shoulders.
Stay big, Cody.
Take your time here and settle him in.
He's in good shape.
They're looking pretty good here. Oh, Green air falls, 5-0. Max Benitz with a takedown, leads 2-0. First period.
Max, oh, and Max already cranked up a half here.
And a half in deep. He had pinned Gerke in the dual meet in 249. He's looking to improve that time here.
Yeah, he's pretty tight on here.
Got a minute 12 left yet. Bennett's working to the for the fall, scooping this near side arm, trying to get some chest pressure on that far side shoulder. Sawyer leads 5-0 with 47 seconds left first period. He is riding. Bennett can try to go around the corner the other way. Got 45 seconds left. Now he's going to scoop the head and the arm, lock them together if he can. The referee in there close, getting a good view.
We got 30 seconds left over here with Max, and he's had this guy on his back the whole time, but we're not going to get any TV of it, so I'm going to be in trouble with the family here.
No, we got that on camera right now.
Oh, now we do.
Three near fall as Gerke ends up going stomach down. And there's 12 seconds left in the period. Cody Sawyer leads 5-0 at the end of the first period in his match. And Benitz is going to run off to out of the mat, end of the period. He is going to take a 5-0 lead into the second. Sawyer on his feet starting the second period. Hard collar tie by the Red Raider. Bennett starts down in his second period, coming to his feet.
We didn't mention we got Arnie, one of the managers, on the camera here. He's busy here trying to get two matches at the same time, so we'll have to get him some lunch or something later on. Although I've heard, Arnie, that you eat quite a bit. Coach Shane's telling me down at Independence you about broke him feeding him, so I don't know if that's
Arnie's
true
just
or
smiling.
Not. Well, he heard the word lunch.
I'm painting him back.
Bennett's with another with a reversal.
I think he'll be okay.
Leading 7-0. Sawyer still on his feet here, minute 15, second period.
So we're dominating two matches here. Maxwell just, this one's going to be really tight over here.
Max Bennett's, we're swinging you over to that match right now. Bennett's again with Gerke on his back. Gerke from Merrill.
Gerke's fighting this for a long time here. Max usually gets people on their backs. They get pretty tight.
This is
going
to get pretty good and tight here. He can get his
I think
back
we just
arched
gotta,
up. He's got the other arm trapped underneath.
I don't know what's keeping his shoulder off the mat here.
He is fighting this hard. Got to give the Merrill kid some credit there.
Yeah, really, yeah.
Gonna scoop the arm again, step around it, lock it down to his chest. Got 30 seconds left.
Yeah, this is it.
Tight for an instant, but that was it. Just an instant.
Come on, Max. Squeeze him up here. Hold him.
Got 18 seconds left. Bennett's looking to settle him in here, and there was the pin.
And even that,
that's pretty
quick. He fought that pretty hard. He just touched him down there. Finally, I think the ref was saying it's enough. This is going to be a mercy killing here. And we've got one going over here with Cody Sawyer.
Sawyer had Loomis out of Stevens Point on his back in trouble from his feet. He leads 9-0. They're going on their feet to start the third. Sawyer had a first round bye at 152 pounds. Hand fighting, trying to get the setup that they want or the grip they want right now, and Sawyer breaks that apart. A minute and a half left. No time to back off now. You got him down 9-0. You can look for at least a tech fall here. Get him one time to the back could be huge. Sawyer with an underhook and head position. 1 minute left. 9-0, the Red Raider Sawyer.
Come on, Cody, pick up the pace.
Slide by. Yeah. I got to get him to the mat. Two takedown. It's 11-0 now. Going to cut him loose, 11-1. 45 seconds.
He's not really aggressive or quick on his feet. Almost seemed like that was a match we should have stayed on the mat, maybe.
Well, they got to hope for one time to the back with enough time to keep him there for five.
And that still won't do it as far as the...
That'll give him a tech fall if he takes him to his back for five. That'll be 16-1. But he may not... He may run out of time on this match. He's got a major here. It's worth one more team point. Yeah, you got to be able to turn that switch up a notch.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, and you got to get the extra points. Again, Red Raider is down a couple of weight classes here, not filling them. It's 11-1. Sawyer with a win at 152.
That's one of the things that, and I don't know, it sounds like being negative, but we've got a couple of guys that don't quite pull the trigger, you know, picking up the urgency in matches like here, because who knows what's going to happen, but late in the match, half a point here, all makes a difference on the final team score.
That is true. We'll be back with more Lincoln High School Red Raider Wrestling on River City's Community Access. Jack Verwin got him at 285 pounds. His opponent, after a first round bye, is Chris Gehrink out of DC Everett. I'll look back in my dual meet results here. Verwin pinned him in 159 in the dual meet.
Jack Verwin was actually the top seed here, which is pretty remarkable considering he's a first-year wrestler. But he's a good athlete. And
he's learning throughout this season how to wrestle these bigger guys a little bit.
He's put some time in. He's been pretty, and he's a pretty good athlete. But he would come in the fall early, and he don't miss practice. He's a good kid. He works at it pretty hard. One of the things that, if it sounds confusing to you folks as you're watching this on TV, it's not a normal bracketed tournament like it used to be. Back when we used to have nine teams, there would be one pigtail and then an eight-man bracket. And then when we lost a couple teams, we lost Antigo and Rylander, so now it's a seven-team conference. And what amounted to was if there was a bye or two, there would be kids that only got one or two matches. And so Scott actually kind of put this together. It's a pool tournament. So
it's a scramble type.
It's kind of a scramble. You put together pools, and then you wrestle two times most guys, if you don't get byes, and then you wrestle your place matches for first, third, fifth, and seventh as you come down the pipe. So it's a little bit confusing, and in some cases, there's still some byes. In other words, if Brock Benitz has two byes into his last match, and most of our kids actually didn't have a match the first round because it looked like the byes were going to get the... We got Mr. Danner, one of the refs, standing right in front of us. He wants
some airtime, I think.
Well, I think his vision, he's in trouble now, Joyce. Whatever. So now we can watch the match again.
Yeah, Mr. Danner figured he had enough airtime now, so he...
No. News and sportscast.
5 seconds left, and we're still on our feet here with Verwink and Gehrink. And Gehrink has been tossed around a little bit by Verwink. He's got him moving with that two-handed collar tie, but hasn't been able to take him down or and get behind him. So we're 0-0 after one period.
The thing you worry about, and this is what he was able to stop the last time, is you get big heavyweight when you're pretty inexperienced, and it means that you're probably vulnerable for a roll. And, right. I thought when I watched that dual meet up there before, he was able to stop that. So now
Nathan Fuller at 182 pounds against Connor Peterson of Marshfield. His second round match, he had a first round bye. Fuller leads 2-1 on a quick takedown and a cut loose. Fuller wrestling at 182 today. Nice elbow tie and a sweep shot there.
It's a nice takedown. He's tough on his feet. He's really tough on his feet.
Fuller now off to the side. And this is probably the weakest position he's got, is on top. Just doesn't make much headway here. Yeah, he's got an arm pin, but he's out over in front of the head. He's trying to keep that arm cut. Now he just cuts him loose. Minute left, 4-2, Fuller on his feet.
Following the second round, there will be a half hour
front headlock by Fuller. Tried a 2%, but wasn't successful in that.
In that second round, we will be taking a half hour break.
Around the corner, he goes off the front headlock, picks that knee, covers him up. He's got a takedown. He leads 6-2 with 35 seconds left. Berwink and Gehrink back on the mat to start the second.
Well, he's snapping him all over the place, but he don't recover real well. He gave him,
gave him the free ride back to his feet.
So Gehrink actually leads 1-0. And this would be a match that we got to win. Oh, don't be doing that.
The headlock, now he's into a body lock by Gehrink. This isn't good.
This isn't very good here. Come this way.
Berwick able to fight it off.
Come way over. Step way over here, Jack. Come on, Jack. Just step over. Get your two. Come on, get your two. Get your two.
Behind him he goes, but the hands come up of Gehrink. Trip, no, and the scramble, no points anywhere. Fuller going down to start the second, leading 6-2. Berwink just didn't feel his position there. If he could have stepped over, he would have had a two and had Gehrink on his
back.
I think
he was trying to secure the headlock, and I don't think he ever got the elbow. This will be a tough match here yet. He goes to that, gets two hands on the head. I'm going to tell you, I've never seen too many good things come of that. Because you need both hands. And,
Fuller has got Connor Peterson on his back now, working on a pin. And we slide you over to that match. Fuller's got to get a hand underneath that head. Oh, he didn't need to. He ended up spinning him in 2:43.
Oh, boy. Jack Berwink has done everything but score a takedown. They went off the mat again, but he kind of got thrown out of bounds. So he's still trailing 1-0. And he does his snap down pretty good, but he's got to get around behind. He gets into a front headlock, but too deep. He keep that thing a little shallow.
Jared Mata getting ready to go against Brady Lentz out of Wausau West. We'll stay here with the Berwink match. Starting the third period, Berwink down. He will need to be on the move, right on the whistle, not let the big guy get the weight on him. He's up to a high base, to his feet, got to move again here. High base again for Berwink. Now he's got to work on hands, move his feet. Gehrink could get nailed for stalling here. There's 1 point warning, stalling. Now we're tied. Now the escape is huge. There's the one.
He must have warned him before. I didn't see it.
Now we didn't get the point for an escape here.
I think he made a mistake. I think that was a warning.
So they're both on their feet. Mata's been taken down and is match against Lentz from Wausau West. Now they got 2-1 on the board for Verwink, and that's what it should be.
I didn't see the warning. But he can't be getting in that headlock position.
Mata got pinned in 49 seconds by
Lentz.
Brady Lentz.
Lentz actually went pretty good with the four, I think, in the dual meet. Now we got a warning, red.
Back trip, pick the knee.
Atta boy.
Got a cradle. Verwink with a takedown, and he's got him stacked.
Oh, come on,
he rolled through it. Now you got to scramble to your feet. Two reversal.
Oh, we got a back point?
We got a near fall, and Verwink with the escape. A wild heavyweight match. 7-3, 19
seconds.
Now you got to
be careful of that body lock here. Just tie up on the head, Jack. Jack is tired.
Yes, he is. That's 7 seconds left. Stay away from the headlock.
He had a nice flurry there, getting that back punch and takedown.
I think both of them are pretty tired.
Yeah, it looks like, yeah. For heavyweights, they were flying around there pretty hard.
Yeah.
We kind of needed that. And in the meantime, Jared Mata got pinned by Lenz from Wausau West at 220.
7-3, Jack Verwink with a win over the big D.C. Everest heavyweight Chris Gehrink. And Mata, as Coach just mentioned, got pinned in 39 seconds in 49 seconds by Brady Lentz of Wausau West. That ends the second round of wrestling. So now they're going to take a break here in the tournament. I guess we will too. And we'll be back with more of the Valley Conference Wrestling Tournament right here on River City's Community Access. And we're back now starting round number three. The Red Raiders have a tough draw at 106. Cale Benitz taking on Brady Kuntz, who's ranked number one in the state. He's number one seed here in the conference. And Kuntz with a takedown leads 2-0 right off the bat. Kale lost on a first-round pin to Bendini of Wausau East in 48 seconds, had a second-round bye. Now he's taking on the number one-ranked wrestler in the state. And Kuntz with a cradle on Benitz. Matrix Jisco on the mat as well. Matrix is taking on Devin Schutz of Merrill.
Leg is in. Ball. Leg is in.
Pin in 46 seconds for Brady Kuntz. And we'll slide you over to the Jisco match over here. Jisco again taking on Devin Schutz of Merrill. These two, I have to look back and see here in the dual meets. These two met up. Schutz was up at 126. He pinned Noah Hanke in 316. Jisco faced Bradley Lyskow, pinned him in 123. 1 point Jisco, unsportsmanlike conduct, headbutt by Schultz. So Jisco with a half minute left in the first, or half minute left in the first period, leads 1-0 on the penalty point. Schultz with a shot, trying to get to a barrel roll. Jisco caught that arm and saved control here. 15 seconds left. Russian arm tie now by the Merrill Blue Jay. Both on their feet neutral with 5 seconds left in the first period. Jisco is going to take a 1-0 lead into the start of the second. Flip of the disc, it comes up red. Jisco's going down. So the Red Raiders exercise their choice there. Ankle picked by Schultz. So Jisco fights through that. He's up to his feet. Tip attempt. Caught Jisco with his shoulders exposed. He's got three near fall. Now Schultz with a 3-1 lead on Jisco. Jisco turns to get a whizzer. Schultz comes up with a single, dumps him. In a scramble, Jisco comes to a double. Changes direction, goes the other way with it. You got to complete this here. Jisco flattened out, now come up with a single. Schultz picking an ankle. One minute left, 3-1. Schultz with the lead right now. And he's got a cross face on Jisco. And he's going to remain in control. Picking an ankle on the far side. And he regains control of the convention ride with 40 seconds left. Jisco's got a score from the bottom here. Arm chopped in by Schultz. He's got wrist control underneath. Jisco's got to fight that free and build up to a base. 25 seconds left. Schultz riding that ankle. Now cradle locked up. Jisco got his head too close to his knee. Near fall coming again. And there's three more on the mat waiting to get handed out. End of the period is coming in 3-2-1. Schultz is going to have a 6-1 lead after two periods. Schultz's choice. He's going down. Jisco's got a big hill to climb here. He stops the first move of Schultz. Schultz can be very defensive here and not really open up. So Jisco's going to have to press the action. Got an arm out. Steps it across the back. Jisco's got it pinned there. Now let's see what he can do. He loses it. Didn't get the arm bar in there high enough. Schultz now to his feet. Turns to face, but they're out of bounds. 6-1, Jisco trails. 1:18 left. Third period. Schultz just bellies down and flattens out. Now builds to a base. Jisco's trying to get hand control. Schultz sits out to face him with wrist control. He's got one on the escape. He leads 7-1 with a minute left. And they're close to the edge of the circle with 50 seconds left. And they're off the mat. Shot from too far out. Schultz with a reshot, Jisco with a counter. Trying to 2%, but Schultz went right through it. Scored the reversal. And there's going to be near fall coming here. Jisco is going to go down to defeat here, I do believe. There's three near fall. It's a 12-1. There's 3 seconds left, 13-1. Matrix Jisco gets defeated by Devin Schultz of Merrill. And the Red Raiders suffer another loss here in the tournament. Next up will be 132-pounder Patrick Spray. He'll take on Nate Duffer to Stevens Point. Follow that with Berg Diebel against Stevens Point's Dylan Trigg. We'll be back with more Red Raider Wrestling. Patrick Spray steps on the mat at 132 against Nate Duffer to Stevens Point. And we'll check back to see if these two met each other in a dual meet. Spray pinned Dufford in 3:23 in a dual meet, and he's in on a nice sweep shot to a single. Dufford trying to lock up around the body. Spray elevating, coming out the backside, trying to in a scramble. He's got the chance to stack Dufford up on his shoulders here. He's got the takedown there, but he got poked in the eye inadvertently in a flurry. Half and a body lock turned him through, but no near fall. And Spray is wiping away on that eye. 1 point free ride back to the feet. 2-1 with 1:10 left. Spray with a fake, got a shot. There wasn't really much of an attempt there. He just dropped down to see if he could get a reaction. There's Spray with a dart in at the knee. Turns the corner, pins it to the mat, now lifts and elevates. Going to stack him up on his shoulders if he can. Trying to catch the head. And Duffer trying to hang on to an ankle. Now Spray's got a cradle lock. He's got 44 seconds left to do something with it. Spray got a first round pin in 150 over Dylan Heath of Wausau East. Spray being ranked number 3 in the state. Snatches that cradle again, scoops him up. Now putting the head in the side, trying to fold him up in half a little tighter. 20 seconds left. Steps over the head to try to get the tip. Got him exposed on his back. 15 seconds left. I don't know if Spray can get the pin as Dufford goes stomach back down. Counting down from 3 seconds, 2-1. End of the first period. Spray opens up a 7-1 lead. Flipping of this comes up red. That's Dufford's choice. He's going on top. Spray is going to be riding. See if he can go to work from the bottom. Spray bases off, looking to get some hand control first, and then he starts his upward descent. Now he's trying to turn inside here and hook a leg if he can while he's got hand control. There he scoots the hips out, turns out and faces, got the one, and back in on a single leg. Covers him up in a scramble. It's now 10-1 Spray with 1.5 left. He's going to cut him loose. 10-2. No, nothing yet. Now it's 10-2. Spray with elbow control and a sweep shot. Pretty takedown. 12-2. 1:15 left. Spray looking for a Turk and a tip. I don't know if he's getting. Now he's starting to get some counts. Oh, he got a count of one. Now we got near fall coming. 55 seconds left, second period. I doubt Spray's going to pin him with that. Now he lets him turn stomach through, but got caught on his back, did Duffert. Spray trying to get in position to get some chest pressure, scoop the head and the arm. 35 seconds left. Spray's got time to finish this off. Pin for Patrick Spray in 3:28. Three 3:28 on the pin time for Patrick Spray at 132 pounds over Nate Duffer to Stevens Point. The Red Raiders will have Berg Diebel coming up shortly. And we'll stay right here because Berg is coming out next. Diebel will take on Dylan Trigg out of Stevens Point. And these two wrestled earlier in a dual meet. Berg pinned him in 5:17. So the nod goes to Diebel in this matchup. Diebel's a guy that never stops moving. He's always The last one moving her, at least tries to be, and that's a good thing in wrestling. You've heard Coach Benitz talk about that a lot. Being the last guy moving, you're usually going to come out on top of things. Diebel with a collar tie now. Still on their feet, no score, 125 left. First period at 138 pounds. This is the third round of wrestling. And we got a stoppage. The headgear coming undone on Trigg. So both in a neutral position, the referee stops that, lets Trigg fasten that back up. Working with 1 minute here. Berg Diebel into a single, but getting stretched out a little bit. Trying to suck that leg up. Now he drops down to a lower one between the knee and the calf, and they go out of bounds. Just ran out of mat. 52 seconds left. Still time for Diebel to take a lead here with a nice takedown. A little arm drag into a single leg. Lifts. Takes him down. As Trigg tried to head out of bounds. Nice setup by Diebel with an arm drag into a single leg. And Diebel gonna put him back on his feet right away. 2-1, 39 seconds left. And we got 25 seconds left here. And we're still on our feet. Trigg on the outside the circle looking in again. Underhooked by Berg Diebel with good head position. And they're off the mat with 15 seconds left. Still 2-1 Diebel. You got time to have a good setup. There's a shot in, but got stopped. Another shot in off a barrel rolls. Got a takedown with 5 seconds left. Max Benitz steps on the mat at 145 against Vince Conan out of DC Everest. And Diebel working on a contact lens. And we'll see if Max Benitz and Conan wrestled during the dual meet. No, they did not. Conan was up at 152. Sawyer beat him 6-1. Benitz with a single leg on him by Conan. 0-0 with a minute left, first period. Benitz got an unorthodox body cradle here. It's not technically right, but good defense right now.
Don't care.
And Conan's off the mat, and they get whistled out. We'll stay with the Benitz match through the end of this period. Keep you updated on the Sawyer match as he leads 4-1. Starting the second period, he is on top and riding. Thirty seconds left, still on their feet, 0-0, Benitz and Conan. Russian arm tie by Max Benitz. Little reach-in shot by Conan. Benitz easily defended that, and Conan's outside the circle looking in again, and a one period, 0-0. Diebel still leading 4-1 and riding in his match. Conan going down to start the second period. Benitz will try to ride. One-point penalty awarded to Diebel. Technical violation on Trigg of Stevens Point. Berg leads 5-2. Benitz working hard here, trying to keep Conan in control here. Knocked him off his base. Thirty-seven seconds left, 5-2 Diebel in the second period, he leads. Conan now up to a high base, 1:15 left. Benitz locks up with one hand, trying to lift him. Warning, stalling Benitz. And 1 point escape, Conan. Five seconds left, 1-0 the Everest Wrestler in the second period. Russian arm tie by the Red Raider Benitz. And he breaks off of that. Sweep shot from a long way out. Benitz pinned the wrist down, but unable to. Front headlock now by Benitz. 28 seconds left, they go off the mat. 1-0, Conan with the lead. Conan getting wrist control and hanging onto it. 12 seconds left, second period. Loose Russian by Benitz. 3 seconds, 2-1, end of the period. 1-0 after two, Conan of DC Evers leads Benitz of Rapids. Benitz choice, he's going down. The Diebel match still going on. Warning stalling on Trigg of Point. And 1:38 left. Berg Diebel leads 5-2 in the third period. Bennett's still on the bottom, trying to come up now. Got to his feet. Got the 1 point and the escape. Now we're tied at one with a minute and a half left. Bennett's into a Russian. Berg Diebel leads 7-3 now and a takedown and a cut loose. Minute 20 left.
Come on, Max.
Jab attempt by Benitz, missed that. Got a leg right there if he wanted it.
Oh, Max.
Double underhooks by Conan. And they're out of bounds. Minute 5 left in Diebel's match. He leads 7-3 on their feet. Shot by Conan, countered by Benitz in the scramble. Around the corner we go, got stopped there. Headlock attempt by Benitz.
Get the takedown, Max. You got it.
Two takedown Benitz. He's got him in trouble on his back. That looks flat, yeah. That's a pin there for Max Benitz. In 5:21.
Wow.
Max Benitz with a 5 minute, 21 second pin over Vince Conan of DC Everest. Berg Diebel is up 9-3 now with 20 seconds left in his match with Dylan Trigg at Stevens Point. And we'll finish the Diebel match as he steps over an arm bar and tried to get near fall, couldn't quite do that with 5 seconds left in the match. Diebel up 9-3. Diebel going to be one of the Red Raiders that this team is going to have to count on heavy for in the upcoming year. 9-3, Berg Diebel with a win at 138 pounds over Dylan Trigg of Stevens Point. Diebel into the finals at 138 along with Pat Spray, Max Benitz, Cody Sawyer will be up next for the Red Raiders. We'll take a quick break, and we'll bring you more of the Valley Conference Wrestling Tournament after we return. Brock Benitz just jumped out from behind us on the mat here at 160 pounds. Against Marshfield's Peyton Young. Benitz with a quick takedown. He's got some near fall coming already. He's up 4-0. And he's got a half, and he's blocked that firearm with a loose bar. And Peyton Young is going to be in a world of trouble here as he stacked him right up over the top. 51 seconds on the pin for Brock Benitz at 160 pounds. Benitz had two first and second round buys, and top seed the group. Got his match against Peyton Young of Marshfield, and it didn't take very long, 51 seconds. Brock's out, done, heading back to the bleachers to rest a little bit. He's in the finals. Dylan Hall ready to go shortly, as is Cody Sawyer at 152, and Nathan Fuller at 182. We'll bring you those matches when we return to the Valley Conference Wrestling Tournament. Nathan Fuller getting set to go here, waiting for his opponent to show up. Fuller at 182 pounds is going to take on Corey Cornea of Wausau East. And here comes Cornea now. We'll see if these two met in a dual meet earlier on. They did. Fuller beat him 13-4 in the dual meet earlier this year. So the nod would go to Fuller here in this heads-up duel.
And this is to get to the finals.
And the winner of this match will face off against another opponent in the finals. The loser goes for third and fourth. Fuller in on a single leg, got it elevated. Back trip, controlling the head. Takes him down, gave up on the pin attempt there. Instead of trying to take him to his back, he's just content with a takedown. Fuller, two weeks ago or so, came off of a heck of a win against Bornbach out of Stratford. He was ranked number one, and Fuller beat him in a dual meet there against Stratford, one of the high points of that whole day.
Yeah, went overtime, and he ran Bornbach out of gas, which really was a big, big plus for us because he's never been known to have the great endurance.
4-2 now. Fuller with a takedown and a cut loose. Stamp tried to get to a slide by, and Cornea backed off that. Fuller with a shot in again.
He's got a good shot there, good technique.
And now he's in danger a little bit of losing a takedown attempt here. Nice little trip. Got the takedown anyway. Wrist now with 10 seconds left. Fuller in control. 6-2 at the end of one period. Flip of the disc comes up red. That's Fuller's color. His choice will be to defer. Cornea's choice, he'll go down. Well, Fuller's going to elect to ride for a while. Ankle pick, stop the first move. Fuller still working on that toe, just with a wrist tied up on the left-hand side. Now he flattens the hips down, steps out across the head, trying to get that arm ripped up on this left side, put it across the back. And Fuller unable to control Cornet. He gets the 1 point escape as he stands up. 6-3, the Red Raider leads. Fuller with a double leg dive in shot and got stopped and backed off of it. And they're coming right into your lap here. And they go back to the center of the mat. Second period. Still 6-3 the Red Raider. Nice sweep shot there. Covers him up with a takedown, 8-3.
Oh, well, I saw East Boy's just hanging on to his hands. He's having trouble breaking free, you know, that attack.
Legs right by Fuller. A little harder to do with the shorter of the body types. 15 seconds left. We'll try to at least control here for the final ticks of the clock. End of two periods, 8-3 Fuller. And he's going down. Cody Sawyer on the mat now at 152 pounds against Wausau West Alexander Hine. Keep you up. Switch you over to that match, I guess. Fuller's got the 1 point in the escape. He's up 9-3.
Pretty critical in some of these matches now because we got a really slow start here. We didn't put anybody into the finals till 132 with Patrick Spray. And then we've kind of reeled off 32, 38, 45. And now we got 52 out here. We're in the finals at 60. And hopefully here with Nate Fuller. Oh, not quite.
Fuller with a takedown attempt, but ended up just out of bounds. Hine not in the lineup for Wausau West when they wrestled the Red Raiders in the dual meet, so this is a fresh matchup with Sawyer and Hine. One-10 left in Fuller's third period. He's still ahead 9-3 on their feet. So far, Sawyer not able to generate any offense. Fuller gets another takedown. He leads 11-3. Then they're off the mat in the scramble with Sawyer and Hine. 11-4, Fuller cuts Cornea loose. 35 seconds left. Looking to get a major.
I don't know this Hine kid. They've had, the old wrestling coach and four wrestlers. He had really good wrestlers, but I never know this guy. And I don't see Dan Hine around at all. So I guess maybe it could be a different family. Who knows?
Both wrestlers in the Sawyer match have been warned for stalling. The old double stalling call. Now it's 0-0 at the end of one. Fuller with 15 seconds left leads 13-4. He got the takedown. He's got a major on the board. I'll give you a quick swing around for the end of that match. Sawyer's going to get a win 13-4. Fuller going to get a win 13-4. And now we're back over to the Sawyer match. Sawyer.
Hine got a escape.
Hine got the escape.
Leading 1-1.
So Sawyer got to work from behind. Hooked by Sawyer, but needs better head position. Head's on the wrong side. Now he's got it, and Hine backs off of that. Oh, 1:15 left, second period, 1-0, Hine with the lead. Fairweather shot him, and they go out of bounds. Hine doing a lot of defense here, not much offense, and Sawyer not turning up the pace on the offensive side enough. Jake Tim going to come out just to our right. First match of the day after two byes. He's taking on Jared Bonke of Wausau West. Jake Tim wrestling at 195 today. Swinging over to the Tim match. First time to look at this Red Raider today.
Boy, Jake. So Jake Tim scores a takedown early here.
And these two did not wrestle. Bonke got moved out of the lineup in the dual meet with the Red Raiders.
Well, Wausau West came without a few guys today for whatever reason. I don't know.
Jake Tim going to cut Bonke loose, give him a free ride to his feet. Sawyer's trailing 1-0, and they're on their feet with 4 seconds left, second period. That's the way that period ends. Sawyer's choice, he's going to go down. Sawyer quickly to his feet, working on hand control. Got the hands separated. Now see if he can score the escape. Hine jumps back in on a single, but Sawyer counters that. And we are tied at one. Jake Tim's got another takedown. Leads 4-1 right now. 30 seconds left. He's on top of riding as we swing you back and forth here.
Cody Sawyer's got to get a little bit of head position here. He's there's no way he can score from where he's at. And they're tied at 1-1, and neither one has come close to scoring a takedown here.
Slide by Sawyer. Can he complete this now? Roll attempt by Hine.
Stay with it. Stay with it.
He said no out of bounds. Mm. Hine really hasn't done a whole bunch here offensively. He's just been defense the whole period.
Yeah. Well, and we haven't done much to
force the issue.
Yeah. He's in that square stance. It's hard for him to get, you know, much penetration out of there. And he can't penetrate with his head where it's at. Boy.
Warning, stalling, Hine, a 1 point Sawyer. They both were warned in the first period.
Now you don't want to be trying too many throws like that sitting on your butt.
Now Hine just bull rushes ahead. Watch the quick call for a stall here against Sawyer. Short drag attempt. They're off the mat.
Boy.
17 seconds left. Slide by Sawyer.
Take him forward. Forward, forward, forward. Take him forward.
There he lifts, close. Takes him down, got the takedown. 4-1, Sawyer with a win.
On the buzzer.
That will slide you over to Jake Tim match. Jake Tim leads 4-1. 35 seconds left of the second period. He's on top of riding with a bar on this near side. Got a wrist trapped underneath on the far side. Jake Tim has been in control of this match from the start, even though it's only 4-1.
Yeah, he's pretty much dominated, even though the score doesn't show that.
Getting a bar tied up on this near side by Jake Tim. 8 seconds left. Dylan Hall set to come out at 170 pounds. We'll stay here with the Tim match. Jake Tim goes down to start the third period on his choice. Caution. Jake Tim jumping to start. Jared Bonke of Wausau West going to cover and ride him here. Bonke able to stop the first move of Jake. Got him flat for an instant. Now Jake will try and build a base. Ankle picked by Bonke. Flattens the Red Raider back out again.
That size becomes a factor when you're underneath.
For spectators,
gotta keep that base going.
Upon completion of this round,
now Jake Kim's coming out. As soon as he reached over top.
We will be wrestling one weight class at a time. We will wrestle 106, and we will wait until all matches at each weight class are completed before moving to the next weight.
Jake Tim with a 5-1 lead with a minute 8 left, third period.
Bonke don't have much of a threat here at all. Kind of flailing away. Jake seems pretty safe.
On mat 1. Third place will be wrestled on mat 2. And fifth will be wrestled on mat 3.
Yeah, Jake, he doesn't get out of position very often. There's a nice takedown there. 7-1.
Nice move. They went from a short drag to a single.
Jake Tim with a long arm. Got a nice tight waist wrapped up here. 30 seconds left. Jake Tim now off to the side, looking to get a wrist up. 15 seconds left. Counting down from 3, 2, 1, Jake Tim is going to be in the finals with a 7-1 win over Jared Bonke of Wausau West. Score was a little closer than that, but the domination was there for Jake Tim.
Yeah, he controlled the match real well. And we've got Dylan Hall stepping on the mat here in the third round with
Nate White out of DC
Nate White.
Everest.
And Nate White is the second seed in this way behind Roth from Stevens Point. So this is going to be a big match here.
White with the length reaches in and gets a single of Hall. Now he's got it elevated. Back trip by White. Takes Hall down. He leads 2-0 to White. Hall's working on trying to break the grip underneath. As White gets a bar and a tight waist now. Blood time on White of DC Everest. We'll recap a couple of the matches for you here. Kale Benitz at 103 pounds is going to be wrestling a DC Everest Maya Veenstra for fifth place. Matrix Jisco will be wrestling Wausau East Nick Budleski for third place. Patrick Spray in a championship at 132 against Marshfield's Anthony Canable. Berg Diebel in the championship against Merrill's Aiden Ball. Max Benitz in the championship at 145, his opponent yet to be determined. At 152, Cody Sawyer. is in the championship. Again, his opponent yet to be determined. And at 160, Brock Benitz in the championship round. Wrestling for first. We're back with the hall match now as White cleaned up and ready to go again. All with a stand-up attempt, and White chops that arm in and stops it. Got a bar on the right side. Bar on her wrist, trying to turn Paul, and he's got him on his back for some near fall. Bar again by White. And Hall's in some deep trouble here. 40 seconds left. Hall's gonna fight this pin attempt off. White trying to reposition. He's over kind of far, but we'll see if he can put enough pressure on Hall's shoulders. 25 seconds left. Hall trying to roll through it. And off the mat they work. 3, near fall, 5-0. White of Everest leads. Seconds left. Hall's got a chance to score here if he can get to his feet. White dogged on that ankle, stopping the first move of Hall.
White just stayed right down there and kind of rode him out, and we were trying to get away instead of getting back into him. Well, we got some time to make up here.
White's choice, he defers. Hall's choice.
Go on your feet, Dylan.
Going on their feet.
Now he's got to protect his legs a little bit.
Oh, what a shot. White with a reshot, and White got there. Now Hall's trying to stretch him out. Off the mat.
Stretch out, Dylan.
White powers right through that single leg attempt and the counter of Hall. He takes him down, leads 7-0 right now. Arm bar and a wrist, and Hall gets run right over. Hall fights that arm free. 3 near fall, it's up to 10-0 right now with 38 seconds left. Second period. And they work off the mat. Five seconds left in the second period. Hall's down by 10. Hall back to his feet, gets the 1-point escape. And somebody's bleeding. And blood time on Everest. Got a nick by the corner of the eye there. Dylan's down 10-1. Again, we've talked about this before. He is dangerous.
Yeah.
But it's a big hole to come out of now.
Yep, it is. And he reaches for the hit even when he got taken down there. White got in on a single, and then he went over the top of the head looking for a front headlock rather than just trying to get that head down and back off. So that's all stuff that I guess we all know, but so... Are we on our feet out here? I think
we
are.
I don't remember. I think we are, but are we on our feet guys out here? Close up. Going down. Up next for the Red Raiders at 220 pounds, Jared Mata has a bye in the third round. He lost his first, or he won his first round match, lost his second round match. And Jack Verwink yet to go against Wausau West, Austin Winter in his second round match. Verwink coming off a heck of a first round match, 7-3 win over the DC Evers full-size heavyweight in Goering. So it'll be interesting to see Verwink come back out again.
Yeah, we talked if he can keep from getting big points scored on him and getting in trouble, he'll win most of these kind of matches.
And again, you're talking about an undersized heavyweight by weight. And you want to stay out from underneath all that weight as much as you can. You want to attack at an angle from the feet. You don't want to be straight in underneath.
Well, most of our team, Scott reminded me the other day, though, that cutting weight isn't always the answer. When Zach and Devin, those guys were seniors, we put 7 guys in the finals of the state tournament, which is unheard of. And we all went out for breakfast before weigh-ins. Zach wrestled at 170 and he's wrestling at 165 yet in college. So
the final round,
cutting weight isn't always the answer, but we are pretty undersized here. Dylan really is a 52 pounder.
We will start the championship replacement matches
third, at 130. Third period coming up, 10-1 now. And they're going to give White the free ride. So now it's 11-1. All working on his feet.
Would be a good time to refuel at the concession stand. Also, 50-50s up to $186. 50-50 will be drawn at 2 o'clock.
Front chislock by Hall, and they go out of bounds. And White is still bleeding. Blood time again on White.
Well, the one thing with Dylan, he always can, you hope he can pull a rabbit out of the hat.
Yeah.
He throws pretty well against guys his own size, and if he can set it up. But we're down 11-1, and like I say, White's a pretty good wrestler. I've watched him over the years kind of come along. And
he's a lot longer than Hall is, too.
Yeah, he's pretty good wrestler.
Matt cleanup going on here yet a little bit. And we are just about ready to go here, I think. They're on their feet with 138 left. Hall trails 11-1. And I'm sure Everest knows Dylan Hall's strength. They're going to try and stay out of that throwing position.
Everest kids always wrestle well late in the season. Eric's a good coach. They got some good coaches. But that wasn't the time to try and throw that.
They tried to definitely force that.
Wow.
To take down White. 13-1, minute 7 left.
I know there's some urgency, but there was nothing to be had out of that.
Well, that was just forcing it.
But like I say, Eric Lurkey's a really good coach, and technically they get better always at the end of the year. You'll always see a handful, or one or two or three kids from Everest down at the state tournament. They end up making their way through there. I don't know if they have any real bona fide studs there. And then again, I'm not so sure how many are in here today. We'll see. We'll see in the next couple of weeks.
White cleaned back up again on the blood time, and now Hall's setting ready to go on the bottom.
Get back. Back into him, Dylan.
Ball almost out, but then White dives back in and catches a leg.
Pretty tenacious.
Yeah, he doesn't stop and let up, does he? 13-1 with just under a minute left. Ball stands back up again. Trip by White takes him back to the mat.
He's not getting that hand free around the waist. Wrestling hard.
Five seconds left. And we're counting down from 10 seconds. White with a 13-1 lead over Dylan Hall, and that's probably the way this match is going to end.
I don't think we got a lot of that on camera. We still got the referees that sit in our way, the one anyway.
In any event, Nolan White takes out Dylan Hall. Hall will be wrestling for third place. And now Jack Verwink will be heading out.
Excuse us.
Dan.
Hey.
Dan.
We're trying to watch the way on TV here. Would you ask Danner if he can just kind of scoot out of there? We're trying to get that match there.
All right, now we got some
we're gonna be able to
traffic
see the
cleared here a little bit.
Kind of.
And we got a heavyweight coming out here in Jack Verwink. The Red Raider heavyweight's taking on Wausau West Austin Winter. And in the dual meet, these two did not wrestle. They moved Brady Lentz up to wrestle Verwink, and they pulled Winter out of the lineup. So Verwink again with another full-sized heavyweight here at 285. And you can see they scouted Verwink pretty hard. They got the elbows tucked in tight on a collar tie. Looks like a half a lineup difference in size, doesn't it?
Yeah, they are. Well, Jack is a light 215-pounder, 220-pounder. Yeah. And I think the Wausau West boy is probably the full pull.
I was going to say, he's got to be pressing the limits.
Oh, he's got the old slide by going.
He was trying anyway, at least worked against the elbow.
We got to snap him down here. Get one hand on the head.
Verwink's fighting for inside position here with a double collar. There, he snapped him, covers him up. Takedown, Verwink.
50 seconds left, 5-0. That was a nice snap down.
Yeah, he didn't wait long. He got him moving in a hurry. Yeah, you just got to make sure you don't get rolled here. One is okay, two is not good. Verwink, a little side trip, takes him back to the mat. 30 seconds left.
He gets up there pretty high. Attaboy, stay in that ankle.
One thing he doesn't do, he doesn't drive with his feet.
Take him forward here.
Warning, stalling Verwink. 1 point escape.
Ooh.
Winter. So it's 2-1. Verwink with a lead. Snap again by Verwink, but Winter went sprawling ahead, but Verwink unable to capitalize. 2-1 after 2 minutes. Winter deferred his choice. Verwink chooses down, and again, Verwink needs to be moving on the bottom. And Winter trying to pick an ankle up high here, and they go off the mat. Verwink able to get out from underneath the weight that time. Yeah, Verwink again up to his feet in a hurry. Verwink working on hands, gets the escape. He leads 3-1.
That's pretty nice. I think this winter kid looking for some type of upper body throw here.
Verwink's kind of roughing him up here a little bit, though.
He's keeping his position. He can only try that snap down so many times.
But if you can feel that big guy starting to lean into you.
Oh, that's good.
Leg attack.
Yeah.
That you don't see women in heavyweight much.
Well, you didn't see much of it there either.
Well, yeah. Kind of a shadow attempt.
Yeah, that's about it.
Berwick backs winner right off the mat. 1 minute left, second period. 3-1 the Red Raider. Berwick's trying.
Well, you can't keep trying the same thing too much. He caught him that first time really well. Come around, Jack. Come on, buddy.
Once this gets a little bit later on, that may work yet. One more time.
Maybe.
Snapped again. He just doesn't take an angle once he snaps. He still stays dead in front. There was a chance. Oh, he missed it there. And they go off the mat. Winter tried to get to a Russian, but Verwink backed out of that in a hurry. Snap again. And the two periods. Winter's choice. He's going down. They're going to put him back up. It's going to be 3-2.
And again, we've talked about this before with the inexperience. The chance on a guy like this of locking your hands, getting a penalty point against you. It's probably not worth taking the chance. That's why they let him go. Well, he's pulling him all over the mat with an attempt of a snap down, but again, it's you can't telegraph it all over the place.
And an opportunity to basically slide right around him. Verwink dives in, but got squashed coming off the mat.
Probably shouldn't do it. It's a good thing we went off the mat there, I think.
Good thing he didn't get hurt.
Yeah. A minute, 16 seconds left here with Jack Verwink leading 3-2 in the third round of this unlimited weight in the conference tournament.
Again, throwing him around the mat. And Winter tries some type of a single.
He's got to be a little careful there because when he's snapping down, he's pulling him right into himself.
50 seconds left. Verwink again with a snap off the mat. Close to the edge anyway. 35 seconds left.
Keep your head position, Jack. You don't have to take a shot. 20 seconds. I worry about that. I wouldn't do that anymore.
10 seconds left.
Well, he stayed in position here pretty good.
There's a chance to score. Get behind. 2, take down Verwink at the end. 5-2, Jack Verwink in the finals at heavyweight.
Who'd have thunk it? We got a first-year wrestler in the finals of the conference tournament.
And a really undersized heavyweight.
Yeah.
But he did exactly what you said, stayed in position all match.
He did.
He kept the pressure on. You know, stayed at a safe distance to some degree.
He did.
And made enough offense. So that's what you got to do in heavyweight.
That was the name of the game there, was all about position. Yep.
Wrestlers.
We're going to take a quick break. We are going to come back with the placement matches here from the WI Wisconsin Valley Conference Wrestling Tournament.
Okay, folks, back here at the place matches in the Wisconsin Valley Conference Tournament. And our first match here is a 106 with Cale Benitz wrestling for fifth place.
He's taking on Maya Veenster out of DC Everest. Benitz into a double. Got to find a half here. Got the takedown.
When he can wrestle somebody his own size, he's fine. That was a nice takedown. We haven't had a chance to see him get a takedown for a long time.
Give you some updated team scores here.
First place, Coons from Point.
Red Raiders in first coming into this round at 169. Stevens Point in second, 160 and a half. Marshfield in third, 141. Wausau West in fourth, 134. DC Everest in 130. Merrill at 88 and a half, and Wausau East 66. The Red Raiders up over Stevens Point by 8.5.
It's going to be a little squeaky.
And we'll see the Point Panthers a few times in the finals.
Yep, sure do.
Benitz now with Veenstra on the back and got a pin in 112. Cale Benitz finishing in fifth.
That's nice. Big 2 points there. Good to see him win a match. He hasn't had a lot of success lately.
Cale Benitz finishing in fifth place in the Valley Conference at 106 pounds as a freshman. And picks up an extra 2 points for the pin. That's probably bigger than the fifth place finish. You know, for the team score.
Yeah, yep.
Next up for the Red Raiders will be 120-pounder Matrix Jisco. He'll be wrestling for third. He'll take on Nick Mudleski out of Wausau East. We'll bring you that match when we return to the Valley Conference Wrestling Tournament.
Nabel, Cameron Schmeiser, Wausau West third. Second place, Tanner Knabel, Marshfield, and your champion at 106, Brady Coons.
Matrix Jisco in his third place match at 120 pounds against Wausau East Nick Budledski. Now we'll see if these two wrestled during the dual meet season. 2% toss by Jisco right off the bat. He pinned Budledski in 41 seconds and he pinned him here in 23.
Well, that was big. It was big for us and big for him, and he had a subpar match, I thought, his last round.
I agree. It just never moved, feet never came out of the mat, and got taken apart.
You don't feel those tilts coming, and there was no tilt coming here, obviously. And I just talked to him, and he's like my step-grandson. He's a great kid. We just talked. I just said, hey, we could use some bonus points here. And we meet him head-to-head several times.
No Red Raider at 126. And then next up, Patrick Spray in a championship match against Anthony Knabel out of Marshfield. We'll bring you that match when it steps on the mat here at the Valley Conference Wrestling Tournament.
All right, we've also drawn our 50-50 winner. Ticket number 975, 173.
And we're back down to championship matches here at the Wisconsin Valley Conference Wrestling Tournament. Patrick Spray is going to step on the mat in his championship match against Anthony Knable out of Marshfield.
Championship match, Wisconsin Rapids, Spray, and from Marshfield.
Patrick Spray, ranked number three in the state, top seed in the tournament.
Stevens Point, Duffert, then DC Evers, Ingalls, and your fifth place match, Heath.
Spray has gotten two pins so far, one and 150 over Dylan Heath of Wausau East, and a pin in 328 over Nate Duffer to Stevens Point.
This could be a good match. Knable's pretty tough. And I don't think they wrestled in the duel.
No, they did not. They did not wrestle. Oh, they did too. Excuse me. They did too. I just looked that up, and Spray pinned him in 227.
Was it Knable, though?
Anthony Knable.
Was it? These matches are really critical for us for the team standings. Stevens Point has kind of slipped ahead of us on the strength of a couple of championships.
Three of them.
And we haven't had, three of them. The Coons boys and Bailey.
James Bailey.
So we got to start picking it up here a little bit. Now we've got to run to some guys in the finals, but we still got to win them. You already got your second place points.
Knable good at wrestling on the edge of the mat there. As soon as Spray got him moving around a little bit, he was out of bounds all the time. Stevens Point has a wrestler going for third place here and has just taken a 2-0 lead. Spray in on a single leg shot.
Duffert, yep.
Gets to a double leg, trips, works up the body, covers him for a takedown. He leads 2-0. Off the mat they work. 31 seconds left. Spray's contact comes out, I guess. And he's going to try to fix it and put it back in.
The optometrist must really like to come to these. You preach hygiene, and then you see two wrestlers, or one lose a contact on a sweaty mat, and they just kneel down and pull the eyelid back and slap that baby back in there.
At best, a little spit to go along with it.
Usually have to spit on it, I think.
Yeah. Trying hard to flatten Knable out here. The final 15 seconds, Knable staying hard in a base. Yes, that Spray gets a cradle locked up. Suicide style takes him over. The buzzer runs out. 2-0 Spray leads. Spray is going to defer. Knable's choice will go down. Knable set, Spray gonna cover. And Spray reaches across to get that elbow, that far side elbow. They try to elevate their hips and take them over top of the head. Spray's seen that a couple times this match already, so he's ready for that. Got that legs right in on Knable. Working the arm back.
Got a nice cross body ride going here. Knable's pretty tough. He put him right on his bean there. Knable's been starting for him now, I'm sure, there's his whole career. He's beaten some pretty good kids.
Well, Spray trying to get the turn here. Knable a little too fresh yet, probably. Still 2-0 Spray. Again, every match in this placement round counts big. Even if you're wrestling third to fifth, Spray warned for stalling. You can get extra points. When your match, you get extra points. That's huge in a tight scoring battle.
And Duffert from Stevens Point is winning his third place match down here.
Five seconds left, still 2-0 Spray. He's rode the entire second period to this point. Reaching back, gotta watch the knee here. Now Spray sticks the legs right back in. End of two periods is here. Spray with a 2-0 lead. He'll take his choice.
Come on, Patty.
He'll go down to start the third. Spray basing off here until he can get some control of some hands. Abel tried to step into a legs right. Spray blocked that.
9-7-5.
Now Spray's got wrist control.
9-7-3-9. 9-7-5, 1-7-3-9.
Nice reversal.
Good reversal Spray.
Head table.
And no near fall. 4-0 the lead for the Red Raider. And a contact comes out on from Spray again. Back and ready to go. Minute 26, still 4-0 the lead for the Red Raider Spray. Now.
Well, he's going after it.
He's going to have to. Knable's putting up a heck of a fight. One point Knable. Illegal hold.
I don't think he did.
Spray, according to the official. 4-1, Spray with a lead.
Might look like a full Nelson in there because he must have touched hands or something.
50 seconds left.
Stable's got his leg underneath here.
We got
to scoot like heck. We got to scoot like heck. Attaboy, attaboy.
Now he's got a power half cross body style here.
He's got to get his hips on top.
Able basing off.
The concern for that is even though you're in control, you can get pinned.
You can pin yourself. Stevens Point just picked up a pin in their third place match. That's extra 2 points. And the Red Raiders not going to get any extra points here. Pat Spray is going to be the champion at 132, beating Anthony Knable 4-1. First place finish for the Red Raiders. Spray at 132.
We didn't need that over here.
No, we didn't need the extra pinpoints for
from
the
East,
Stevens Point squad.
Myers.
Next up at 138, Bert Diebel will be in a championship Marshfield, against Marshfield. Mitch, or excuse me, Nolan Hurdle. We'll take a quick break and we'll be back with more wrestling on River City's Community Access.
In second place from Wausau.
Championship match now at 138 pounds. Berg Diebel, your Red Raider, taking on Marshfield's Nolan Hurdle. And Hurdle wrestled Max Benitz and won a hard-fought 2-1 match. Berg Diebel wrestled Dawson Tysver and pinned him in 159. So this is a fresh matchup here for these two.
Hurdle name is pretty tough in Marshfield. I had a really good brother here that wrestled, so... it's going to be a tough match, and we need some of these wins. Stevens Point, I think, is one ahead of us in this tournament now.
And they got another wrestler wrestling for third. And Hurdle in on a single. And a trip takes Berg Diebel down, leads 2-0. Diebel trying to stretch out here. And he's going to have the 1 point escape. And they're back on their feet, 55 seconds left. Bye-bye Diebel to the Okeechobee. Can he get his hips up? And they're out of bounds. He was in control, but out of bounds. Too.
Nice move. He worked at it pretty hard. But they did get out of bounds. 41 seconds left. Hurdle from Marshfield leading 2-1.
Berg Diebel got here by a first round bye. And he pinned Ryan Daniel of Wausau East in 2:36. And he beat Stevens Point's Dylan Trigg at 9-3 decision. 20 seconds. Nice for Diebel to get one late here. One good takedown late. Shot in, got stretched out. Trying to crawl into the shot.
5 seconds.
Off the mat and out of time at the same time. And the disc comes up Diebel. He's going to defer. Berg trails 2-1. Diebel trying to get a wrist tucked underneath here.
Can't get Hurdle off his base here.
Diebel goes back into a single leg from their feet. Diebel still in control.
He's in pretty good shape here, really. Gonna keep his hips up. Oh.
Diebel's lifting on that bottom leg. In the scramble we go. Keep that arm trapped under here. Got a half.
That was quite a scramble.
Half. 55 seconds left. Diebel with a legs ride now. With 40 seconds left. Out of bounds. At the very least, Diebel's got to ride Hurdle out, not give him an escape, so he can at least tie the match with an escape in the last period. All right, ankle big driving him to the mat. Diebel in a hard crossface here, trying to get to a cradle. Hurdle's able to reach and grab a leg with 10 seconds left. Diebel picking an ankle to save some control here. End of the period, 2-1 Hurdle leads. Diebel's choice, he's going down. Legs ride stepped into by Hurdle. Diebel steps out of it. Hurdle's got that crossbody arm. Now, Dirtberg on the move, up to his feet, working on the hands. Switch attempt on the way down to the mat. One, loss of control. Gable tied the match at two.
Now, Hurdle got the original takedown.
Off a long scramble.
That a boy.
Down by Diebel.
Careful, careful. He's going to drag you by here, Bird.
Diebel trying to run him over. And Hurdle remains in control. Now he picks a hip. One minute, 4 seconds left. Hurdle still hanging onto a leg.
Stretch him out. Stretch him out, Bird.
Got the grip broke. Now go hard. Crossface hard. Diebel with a takedown. He leads 4-2 right now. 45 seconds left. Diebel back down to a single now as Hurdle trying to stand up. And they're out of bounds in the scramble. 36 seconds left. Diebel 4-2 in the lead. He's on top of riding.
These two kids are real even. It's who gets the last move here, I think, is going to win this thing. Come on, Berg. Drive forward, buddy. Oh,
Hurdle tried to hop over top, put him on his hip.
Not on your hip, though. Oh.
He's able to scoot him out of there.
Yes, he was.
20 seconds left. Claw ride. Hanging heavy on his head and his shoulders. 5 seconds left. Berg, Diebel hanging out after he puts him on his back at the buzzer. Diebel 4-2.
Wow, great match. Great match, Berg Diebel. That was close. That was a close match. And Stevens Point is winning down here in their third place match.
Berg Diebel, a conference champ at 138 pounds with a 4-2 win over Nolan Hurdle of Marshfield.
Great match. He battled at the end.
He did. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be back with the 145-pound championship match on River City's Community Access.
...145-pound championship match. Schwanebeck Osterman from Marshfield versus Benitz from Wisconsin Rapids. In the third place match, Waldron from West, Conan from DC Everest. In your third place bout, Cluck from Point, Gurley from Maryland.
Back now to 145-pound championship match. Max Benitz is taking on Marshfield's Bentley Schwanebeck.
Did we wrestle before?
I'm going to just look this up. They did not wrestle, I do not think.
Whoa.
Schwanebeck into a takedown early.
Ooh, he shot in on a double. I don't think Max is really ready for that.
Nobody's claiming the 50-50. It's 975-1739. The number's also on the board.
Off the mat, they work. 1-41 left first period. 2-0. Schwanebeck, and another contact comes out. Nope, drop that, put it on the floor. And Benitz will be down to start the restart. Schwanebeck will be riding. Caution, improper starting position, Benitz.
That's a cheap call, so you touch the line. Tough way to start here. Build your base, Maxwell.
Schwanebeck riding with just a tight waist right now, driving ahead with shoulder pressure across the small of the back. Well, he's trying to get an arm tied up on the left side, which he has done, and then it's got to fight that free. A bar and a wrist tied up by Schwanebeck. Rolls a tip. One count, no near fall. Bennett's foot off his back.
Come on, Max.
He's
come
still
on,
got
baby.
That arm tied up with a wrist.
Ooh, he's got the wrist underneath. That's a tough ride.
28 seconds left, first period.
Takes a lot of gas, he's so tight across the stomach.
Still, if he can fight this off, he'll stay in the match at 2-0. Roll attempt again. Well, he survived the turn attempts. He's only down 2-0.
That was big. He was in trouble there.
Schwanebeck's choice.
Settle down, Max.
His choice, he defers. Benitz going on their feet.
Got to be ready this time. Got taken down with that double like that right there.
Schwanebeck dogged on that leg.
Wow, this kid's tough in there.
Off the mat they go. Bennett's still being on his feet, neutral.
Well, they've scouted him pretty well too.
Back on the outside looking in. Now he circles towards the center. Takes a shot in at the edge. Picks a leg and they step out of bounds.
Boy, he shoots quick. That's a quick shot. Get some lateral motion here, Maxwell. You gotta control that arm. Come on.
55 seconds left. Shot in again by Schwanebeck, stopped by Benitz. Double leg shot again by Schwanebeck, and he got there, but he's got Benitz on the seat of his step in right now on the edge of the mat. Benitz cross body inside the thigh, locked up. Close to being out of bounds here.
We're a stalemate.
Both up, says the referee. 27 seconds left.
He's got a quick shot there. He gets in there pretty hard. We got to keep our feet moving here, Max. Tying up our wrists. There we go.
Russian arm tie by Benitz. Off the mat. Ten seconds left. Want to back into the
single down,
again.
Wizard down, Max.
And a scramble, no points. 2-0, Schwanebeck leads, his choice.
Schwanebeck is really quick. He gets in there really.
And pretty powerful.
They've scouted him pretty well because Max's best takedown is a snap down, a guy shoots and come around behind, and he's coming in with a double, and he can't do that with a double.
Yeah, he's coming straight in at him instead of on an angle.
They got some concerns here, and I don't know what it is.
Schwanebeck starts down in the third period. Bennett's on top. And it's trails 2-0. Schwanebeck staying hard in a base. Roll attempt coming. Bennett's countered that the first time. Roll again.
Get that wrist, buddy. Get it. Get it.
Stevens Point has a wrestler in the fifth place match, leading 5-2.
They're wrestling really well today, Stevens Point is. Chop it in. Get the wrist. Get the wrist, Max.
1:15 left. Bennett's still on top. Schwanebeck on the bottom. Schwanebeck to a high base. Bennett knocks him back off the base. Schwanebeck to his feet, but they step off the mat. Schwanebeck will be down. Bennett will cover with 49 seconds left.
So we're starting from the other side. Get that wrist under, Max. Well, Schwanebeck don't quit moving on the bottom.
No, he doesn't. He stays hard on the base here pretty much most of the time. Now he steps up to the mat. 30 seconds, they're off.
Yeah, break him down.
Now they're going to put him on their feet. 3-0. Back's got to attack, though. Can't burn time off the clock. Schwanebeck shoots in. Got a single. Not quite able to catch him here. But didn't get a takedown either. Trying the 2%. Schwanebeck stands right up through it and gets a takedown. And he leads 5-2.
Almost got him with the half and the Nelson there. And then Schwanebeck come back and countered that and got the takedown. So it was one of those that could have went either way right there.
5-0 Schwanebeck. Tough loss for the Red Raiders. Schwanebeck late in the lineup for the Marshall Tigers and becomes a Valley Conference champion at 145 pounds. Max Bennett's finishing in second place for the Red Raiders. Next up, 152 pounders. Cody Sawyer against Tanner Pettitamaro. We'll bring you that after a short break.
Tough match, and I'm not sure who won.
Our 52-pound place matches. In championship bout, from Merrill, Pettit. From Rapids, Sawyer. Third place, Maburka. And Hine from West. In fifth place, Mitchell from Marshfield. And Loomis from Point.
Cody Sawyer in the championship match against Merrill's Tanner Pettit. This is at 152 pounds. Cody Sawyer was moved up to 160. Tanner Pennant pinned Alec Dickerson in the dual meet. Right now, Stevens Point leads 186.5 to Wisconsin Rapids 185. And Pennant's in on a single leg shot. And Stevens Point has another wrestler out, wrestling for fifth. Two, take down Pettit. Sawyer's set on the bottom. Pettit's going to cover.
Didn't quite get our hips out enough there. It was a nice roll attempt.
Sawyer trying to hang on to a wrist control here and get up to a bigger base. Pettit's got the leg scissors apart with his left arm.
That's tough ride.
Now Sawyer back to a base.
Don't reach over. Scooter. Well, I'm on air, right?
As far as you know.
Come on, Cody.
There, he's got the 1 point in the escape.
So with 35 seconds left, Pettit from Merrill leaves Sawyer from Rapids 2-1.
Pettit controlling her wrist pretty hard here on Sawyer. Pettit reached in with a shot and they're off the mat. Five seconds remaining. Sawyer's going to trail 2-1 to start the second period. A flip and a disc comes up. Red, Sawyer's choice. He defers. Pettit's choice. He'll go down. Got some wrist control, but Pettit's already up to his feet. Well, Sawyer lifts, takes him back to the mat, but they're out of bounds. Pettit had the hardest start of the two that time. See if Sawyer can up the ante a little bit here. Pettit up to his feet. Sawyer got to do something with him, try and get him back down. He cuts him loose. 3-1, Pettit leads. And Pettit with a shot into a single and got it locked up.
Come on, wizard that hard. Throw it, throw it, throw it, throw it, throw it. Oh, you're the same thing. Leaves that leg in there and he dug it right out.
Wizard saved the takedown attempt. He ran out of the wrestling mat.
He came out of that flurry pretty well.
He would have been on top with Pettit in some deep trouble. But you can't let it get that far.
Yeah, right. Yep. His last, the guys we've had in the finals aren't shooters. None of them. Not again. Not again.
Hard whizzer again by Sawyer. Gotta stay with it hard here and get that leg out. Out of bounds, stalemate. In the fifth place match, Stevens Point trails 2-1, a minute left, second period. They're locking up on the hands, not letting Sawyer get to that slide by collar tie that he likes, that he's pretty good at.
But it won't work unless the guy ties up on your
right
neck.
That's why they've been hanging on to the wrist pretty hard.
Pettit shoots that single pretty good.
Now look at the score here. But Pettit got hand control again. Eight seconds left.
Snap him down. Come on, come on, Cody.
3-1, Sawyer trails after two. Sawyer's choice, he's going down.
Work a base, Cody, come on, buddy.
Pettit again with wrist control underneath. 2-on-1. Sawyer stretches out to break the grip around the tight waist and wrist. Now he's got to build back up to a base. Pettit again with the arms scissored in between the legs.
That's a tough ride.
Stalemate. 1:14 remaining.
Don't lose your base, Cody. Come on. Come on, don't lose your base, Cody. He starts reaching back there, and then he loses his base. And Pettit rides pretty tough with his through the crotch ride.
50 seconds remaining. And it's got a wrist, chest pressure with the shoulder in the middle of the back. Now we got a chance to scramble here.
He keeps stepping back into it, makes himself an easy ride.
30 seconds. And it drops down to a single, buries his head.
Get your one, Cody. Get your one here, buddy.
Off the mat they work with 10, 11 seconds left. That was the best start Sawyer had, but he may be a little too late here. 1 point escape, they're off the mat. 3, 2, 2 seconds left.
Too little, too late here,
I think. Yeah, that was the best start he had. Went back up in and up instead of ahead. End of the match, 3-2. Cody Sawyer goes down. He will finish in second place at 152. The only good news is Stevens Point is getting beat and just did get beat 7-2 in the wrestleback match for fifth. So they did not gain any more points either on the Red Raiders. We'll take a quick break. We'll be back with more wrestling on River City's Community Access.
From Marshfield, Bentley Osterman Schwanbeck.
Championship match, Brock Benitz against Fritz Sherrill. Probably the feature matchup of the tournament amongst the ranked wrestlers. Benitz ranked number 2 at 160. Sherrill ranked number 3 at 160. Sherrill with a takedown on Benitz. Benitz
Last
turning back into a single.
Original 50-50 winner.
It's the reversal. It's 2-2.
5-3. We will be drawing another number.
Legs ride by the Red Raider Benitz.
Winning ticket number was 975-17.
Sherrill stands up with legs ride in on Benitz. That's potentially dangerous.
We'll draw another number.
Well, these are two of the best in the state, obviously. And it's 2-2. It's been quite a flurry here for this little bit of time. They've rocked pretty well.
Sherrill rolls out of that, gets the easy escape, and it's 3-2. Sherrill a point. Front headlock by Sherrill on Benitz. And they're off the mat. Both up, 3-2 Sherrill, 50 seconds left. Slide by Sherrill, missed. Twenty-four seconds left, first period. Sherrill fights his way into a front headlock. Off the mat they work. And And 17 seconds left, both still on their feet. Got 5 seconds left.
Sure won't come out of position.
End of one period, 3-2, Sherrill with the lead. Flipping a disc comes up green. Sherrill's Benitz's color, excuse me, he defers. Sherrill will take down. Sherrill set, Benitz covered. Sherrill jumping to start. Caution.
Get ready, back.
Crab ride by Benitz. Sherrill picking the hands, trying to get a leg.
He's got his leg on the trouble.
Now, Sherrill's got Benitz's leg.
That's potentially dangerous.
Two reversals, Sherrill. Sherrill rolls Benitz on his back with a double armbar here and pins him. Britt Sherrill rolled Benitz on his back with a double armbar and stuck him in at 2 minutes 30 seconds. Two big kids in the state there at 160, and one guy not so happy, one guy really happy.
Well, it got to be a flurry there, and Brock was trying to turn him with a leg in the power half and never got to that point, got his leg hung up. Sherrill came back, took that leg in the air, and was able to put that half on him, and it was just kind of a flurry. They'll meet again, I'm sure.
Yeah, down at state tournament, you're probably looking at it. Two guys probably looking to qualify, I would imagine. In any event, Brock Bennett's finishing in second place at 160 pounds. Next up for third, Dylan Hall will take on Kyle Krizan out of Marshfield. That's at 170 pounds. We'll be back after this short break.
Tanner Bennett. Our championship bout from Point Rock, Everest White. Our third place bout.
We got a third place match here, 170 pounds. Dylan Hall against Marshfield's Kyle Krizan. Red Raiders need a little pickup here, as Point is out in front of the Red Raiders in this tournament. Krizan and Hall, they did not meet in the dual meet earlier in the year. So this will be a fresh matchup. And Krizan in on a single leg on Hall.
And Hall gets taken down. They've been doing a very good job of countering those leg attacks. These guys are relatively the same size. This guy's going to 60 next week. We've been giving up that original takedown quite a bit here lately.
And then you got to climb out of that hole from behind.
Oh, don't sit on your butt, though, Dylan.
Dylan Hall trying to lift a leg and figure out a position where he can score here.
We're going
to
go out of bounds if he does score. You got to have one. Oh.
1 point loss of control, Krizan. 1 point Hall. It's 2-1, Krizan of Marshfield.
There you go. Hold it right there, bud. Bam!
Stevens Point has a wrestler in the championship at 170 pounds.
And he's the number one seed. That's Joey Roth wrestling White. I can't think of White's first name.
Nolan White. Hall with a headlock. Can he catch him? No. Hall gets rolled through on his back in deep trouble.
Oh,
Hall's got 25 seconds to fight this off.
Oh, that's a tight headlock, too.
Ten seconds left.
Get your feet on the mat, Dillon.
Dillon's fighting that shoulder up. 3, 2, 1. All survived. 3 near fall. He's in a 7-1 hole. Krizan's choice. He defers. Hall's choice. He's going down. Hall to his feet, working on hand control. Anchors on, lifts, takes him back to the mat. Hall back to his feet again.
Stay with that hand, Dillon. Just get your one. We
Hall has hooked that leg on the inside here. Looking to turn in. He's going to get the reversal. Can he keep a half? Got near fall coming. Grapevine in the legs. This could get tight, and it was. Wow. Wow. Big dig out of the hole there by Dillon Hall.
Really was, yeah. And he didn't quit. I'll tell you what won him the match was him fighting that headlock off in the first period.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe a minute, you know. He was in deep doo-doo, and he hung in there and come back and got a reversal. Got a fall, so.
Pin was in 239. That was a little bit of a lifesaver for the Red Raiders. Yeah. The extra team points there.
Has stopped the bleeding a little bit.
Roth is going to be the favorite in this match in the championship side here. We'll take a quick break, and we'll be back with more Lincoln High School Red Raider Wrestling.
And your champion at 160 pounds from Stevens Point, Fritz Sherwin. From Wisconsin,
182-pound championship match. Sam Stroik and DC Evers taking on your Red Raider, Nathan Fuller. Be nice to get some pinpoints here for the Red Raider Fuller if he could possibly do it. The Red Raiders are trailing as we speak. 192.5 for Stevens Point to 189 for the Red Raiders. So here's Fuller and Stroik.
I think Brock wrestles Stroik in the duels.
You're right, he did. He wrestled Stroik in the duels.
I think he pinned him in the first period, if I'm not mistaken.
Yep, in a minute.
Points back out here
for fifth and sixth
place match. And there's a lot of difference between first and second and fifth and sixth. Oh no. Put your hips up, get them up. Oh my goodness.
And Point just pinned the Marshfield kid who didn't know where he was at on the mat. And
oh,
they pick up another
beat too.
2 points bonus. Fuller on the mat now with Stroik. Ankle pick by Fuller, drives in, takes him down. Now he's got the leg scissored here. See if he can use that for a turn and a pin. Don't let the leg slide through now. And he jumps out of that. Seconds left. Fuller has over-the-shoulder wrist control. And he's lifting on the leg, but it's not a leg ride. Cradle now locked up by Fuller. Fuller going to survive the first period with a 2-0 lead off the takedown. Flip of the disc comes up. Red, Fuller's choice. He defers Stark's choice. He goes down. Red Raiders into their championship round. Black singlets with the red and white trim. Fuller just trying to hang on to Stroik here. Wasn't any kind of a start. Now he cuts him loose. 2-1, Fuller with a lead. Arm drag into a single. Trying to keep him in bounds, but Slake's going backwards. Minute 20 left, second period. Front headlock by Fuller. Look to score here, Nathan. Inside leg trip, that Gomez as you called it, but they're off the mat.
Come on, Nate.
Seconds left.
Come on, Nate.
Stroik reaches in for a shot, trying to get to a double. Fuller trying to spin around the corner here. Time for a short drag, and they go off the mat. He just drives them backwards. 34
he's
seconds.
He's got to keep Stroik from tying him up. He's real quick, and Stroik is just like slowing him down. Nate's best stuff is the quick shots. It's in motion, Nate, buddy.
Chin lock, reaches into a single, Stroik with an underhook, and wrist control.
Come on, Nate. Pick up the attack here a little bit.
Yeah, Fuller can't be content with just a 2-1 lead.
Well,
he's got to light it up here a little bit.
We got a guy that we should really be dominating here.
Fuller ranked 6th. And he ran out of time to complete the takedown. Fuller's choice, he's going down, leading 2-1. Fuller bases off, stands up pretty easy. Working on hands, trying to hit a switch on the way down. No control loss. Cradle tries by Stroik. Fuller turns back inside and gets an underhook and the escape.
Come on, Nate. Now score on this. Don't let him hang out.
3-1 Fuller. Stroik working hard on trying to tie up both arms, and so far he's done well at that.
Yeah, and Nate's kind of allowing that to
right.
happen. Finish up, Nate. Come on, come on. He's looking at the clock. He's being way too passive here. We need some points.
Stroik got stretched out. Now Fuller trying to counter this takedown attempt. Now he's got a chance to score. Heading the side around the corner he went. Takedown 2 leads 5-1. Crossface. Here's the hard work here. Cradle locked up by Fuller.
Knock him over. Come on, get that hip in there.
Oh, and he backs off of it. Pinning combination locked up, and he just turns it loose. Man. 35 seconds left. Little shuck on by, but missed gone away by 20 seconds. 5-2 Fuller. Duck under attempt.
Yeah, it's kind of surprising me because Stoik is not one of the stronger wrestlers here, but I guess he came out to slow Nate down.
He did that. It was 5-2. Nathan Fuller, champion at 182 pounds. Over Sam Stoik out of DC Everest. Next up at 195 pounds, Jake Tim against Nate Engel of Stevens Point, and I would think that Engel would be the favorite in that match.
Well, I'd agree, yeah.
So we'll take a quick break and we'll bring you that match when we return to the Valley Conference Wrestling Tournament. Now, here's Jake Tim steps on the mat. Championship match, 195 against Nate Engel out of Stevens Point.
Championship 195 from Point Engel from Rapids, Tim.
The Red Raiders forfeited to Engel up at 220 in the dual meet. Engel very physical.
I think the goal here would be to stay in this match as long as we could. Engel was out of the lineup quite a while with a football injury, the way I hear.
Shoulder, yeah.
Something.
And he.
So the plan is to try and stay in here.
Front chin lock by Engel. Jake Tim picks the hands off there. Jake Tim wades into a shot, got countered. Headlock, pinch headlock. Engel gets the takedown. Jake Tim's in some trouble here.
Little pinch headlock.
Jake Tim fighting this off as hard as he can. Now Engel switches to a half Nelson and some chest pressure.
Yeah, that would have been the goal. To try.
And there is the pin for Engel in 53 seconds.
The idea would have been to try and get through, like I said, those first here periods. Jake's got really good endurance, but he got squeezed up an old pinch headlock there.
And you're looking at a guy that's probably 170-pounder, you know, going up to 195 for the team, and you can see the difference in the body size there. Engel much thicker and bigger.
Yeah. And it's not, in a way, it's not just for the team. That's the only spot that was open, you know.
Right.
That's basically where it's at.
So
I think we've fallen behind a little farther. Huh?
Yeah, I would imagine so. Not getting a win, and then Stevens Point just getting six more with the win. Difference between first and second and the pins. So could come down to the wire, and I'm not sure if we got enough bullets left to do anything with it right now. We're going to meet them in the heavyweights at 285. Brandon Pataka, Stevens Point, and Jack Verwink going first.
Who does Mata wrestle here at
220? Mata gets Merrill's Christian Kleinschmidt for third place at 220 pounds. That'll be the next match on the docket here for River City's Community Access. We'll take a quick break, and we'll be back when that match steps on a mat here at the conference tournament. 220-pound third-place match for the Red Raiders. Jared Mata against Merrill's Christian Kleinschmidt.
220, Lentz from West, Corvino, Everest. Your third-place match, Mata from Rapids and Kleinschmidt from Merrill.
Kleinschmidt pinned Mata in 32 seconds in the dual meet earlier in the year.
Oh, and he was in good shape, and then he got himself flattened out here. Oh, no.
This isn't a good position here for Mata.
He could get this. Oh, he could still get it.
And, well, we got 3-2 Kleinschmidt. No. 3-2 Rapids, according to the scoreboard. I'm not sure that one's right. I don't know what. We'll have to check that out.
Basically, I thought it should have been 2-0.
No, 3-2 Kleinschmidt of Merrill. Now they got straight with a minute left, first period.
Yeah, don't be down there, though. Come on, come on. The size hurts him.
Oh, yeah, this is a full-size 220-pounder here, and he stepped over the top of that front headlock.
Pull your knees up!
Dude, take down Kleinschmidt. Mata's in trouble, and he got pinned again. In 118. Mata goes.
Stevens Point, Patoka. And your third place bout is between.
Here is your championship match at 285 pounds. Wisconsin Rapids senior Jack Verwink taking on Brandon Patoka out of Stevens Point. Patoka not in the lineup for the Panthers. When they wrestled the dual meet, Jack Verwink beat Jacob Erdman 4-2 in the dual meet. Two small size 285 pounders.
Well, we're kind of, I don't know if we're going to win this tournament. We can't, but it's kind of up in the area with the dual meet standings where we're going to fall. I didn't even want to speculate on that. I guess the first thing is we're head-to-head with Point, and we got to try and win this last match.
Now, again, Verwink used to wrestling the big rounder, 285-pounders, and he's made that double collar tie work to some degree. This is a totally different body style to wrestle. This is somebody more his size, 210-pounder. So some of that same style of wrestling may not work.
Yeah, he looks pretty strong too.
Seconds left, 0-0, still no score. Berwick trying to snap, now driving in. Trying to pick a leg, couldn't get there with that. Again, a bigger heavyweight may have went underneath, lost balance, but lighter, more agile guy, able to stay on his feet and keep his balance. And the headgear has come basically unsnapped or apart on the face mask of Patoka. 15 seconds remaining. Five seconds left, still 0. Verwink in with a shot, and they're out of bounds.
I think he might have got that if we had a little more math there.
Yeah, if he was started on the far side.
It was a nice shot, yeah.
End of one period, we're tied at 0. Flipping a disc, comes up green. That's Pataka's choice. He's going down. They're gonna cut him loose, give him a 1-point escape. Pataka with a 1-point lead now, 1-0.
Yeah, that's what they've been doing most of the time with him, and I guess that's, we've been winning, so I guess that's a good choice.
Hard snap by Verwink. Pataka went flying around the mat, but unable to capitalize on it.
Haven't seen an offensive move out of Pataka.
No.
At all.
Not one. Erwin again. again driving in. They're out of bounds. Five seconds left. Still 1-0 Pataka.
Oh. I don't think Pataka shoots. I don't think he shot at all.
No, he hasn't done anything offensive.
20 seconds. Hopefully, before this is over,
hard snap.
Berwin can take a good shot at him.
Yeah, but Taka just flung an arm out, gave it a token look, maybe.
Yeah.
That's about all it was. It's not even an athletic effort there. End of two periods. Pataka leads 1-0 on the gift from Verwink. Now Verwink's choice. He's got to go down. Verwink on the bottom now to start the third period. Oh, they put him back up.
Same thing.
1-1.
I think you got two inexperienced wrestlers here, and the coaches are just trying to avoid mistakes.
Putting them in a. The referees stop the action there. Going to have a quick conference with them about head-to-head action there.
Yeah, it might have been a little headbutting. Their faces are both getting kind of roughed up. And Pataka's using that face mask on Verwink's face here. Pretty hard to get head position when you got that hard piece of plastic in your face.
1:20 left. Verwink again reaching in. Pataka tried to counter, but they're out of bounds. Verwink's had all the offense.
Yeah, eventually we might get a stalling, but it might be too late here. There's no warning at all yet.
Seconds left. Verwink again fighting for that double inside collar tie there. Pataka's just defensing. That's all he's done.
He is. He's using that face mask, right? Verwink's face is pretty red and roughed up. Starting to look like a heavyweight match. Just two guys pummeling or whatever.
30 seconds.
Doing.
Verwink again drives in. Pataka backs off the mat.
I'm seeing stalling here.
Yeah, I haven't seen one offensive move by Pataka yet. Verwink trying to force him down into a front headlock. Into a double, takes him down with 4 seconds left. Verwink with a 2 and a takedown. 2 ticks on the clock left. Verwink.
Atta boy, Jack Verwink.
Talk about staying with it long enough till it works, ain't it?
Really?
Wow.
That was tough. That was tough.
Ah, they're going to put him back up on their feet. Got to stay in good position here. 2-3-2 Jack Verwink, a heavyweight champion of the Valley.
Wow. He got the worst of that head beating there. His face looks pretty messed up. But boy, I'll tell you, that was a perseverance there.
And a team going to go over to congratulate him.
Well, they should. That's big.
220-pound place finishers.
Big match for the Red Raider. 285-pounder. Champion in the Valley Conference. 3-2 win. over Brandon Pataka out of Stevens Point.
Wisconsin Rapids, Jared Otta.
That's coming a long way from starting as a senior, isn't it?
Sure is, yeah. Yeah, he's a tough kid. He's battles. He does have that ability to shoot that double.
And your champion from Wausau West.
If he could do it from the other side of the net,
right.
I make it a little easier.
It made it pay off. All right, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back with some updated points totals and maybe an interview with head coach Scott Benitz. We'll be back with more Red Raider Wrestling on River City's Community Access.
Austin Winter was in fifth.
Safe travels.
You too.
I'm going to.
Back now at Merrill High School, and head coach Scott Benitz stopping by. Congratulations, Scott. After all the point totals and figuring it up, today's tournament, Stevens Point 202.5, Wisconsin Rapids 197. Add that to the dual meet totals, where the Red Raiders finished undefeated. Red Raiders come out on top of the Valley Conference, winning an overall title. Congratulations on that.
Thank you. Yeah, we probably could switch our lineup around to win the tournament today. We knew we had to stay ahead of Wausau West, and it's kind of how we geared things. So.
Red Raiders, go through the lineup real quick. Fifth place for Cale Benitz. Got a pin there at the end.
Yeah.
2 points there for him at the final, finishing in fifth over Maya Veenstrom.
Yeah, it was probably as good as we could have hoped to do.
Right.
You know, he's all year. You know, he's been small, and he gets guys his own size. He's okay. And today the guys were bigger and kind of struggled a little bit.
Yeah.
But was able to win the last match, and that's, you know, it's always nice to find a win, finish on an odd number, and
right.
He did a nice job.
Nova wrestler at 113, as the case for all year. Matrix Jisco at 120, coming in third. Maybe something not what you were looking for there.
No, well, Devin Schultz is pretty good. He's been at 26-32 all year, so we knew we were going to struggle a little bit with his size.
We had your attention.
We actually were in pretty good shape at end of the first period, up 1-0. Didn't feel that tilt, and gave up that tilt, and then went downhill.
All the champs.
Nobody at 126 today for the Red Raiders. Pat Spray, champion again at 132 pounds, 4-1 win over Anthony Knable of Marshfield.
Yeah, it was a hard-fought win. Pat's not feeling real well, and you can see he didn't have quite the energy that he typically wrestles with. And Knable's very good, and it was a good match. We controlled it.
Right.
But there are some flurries in there, some, you know, spots in there where Knable made it a little bit interesting, but. You know, overall, it was a real solid match. Pat did what he had to do, scored from down,
right.
Got a takedown, rode well on top, so he did all the small things, and that's why he's as good as he is.
And he won all three positions on the mat, like you just mentioned.
Yep.
132-pounder Berg Diebel, conference champion, taking out Nolan Hurdle of Marshfield 4-2.
Yeah, it was interesting right at the end. I thought he was going to give her away when he's going to roll over on his, you know, his back out of there, but... Russell, a good solid match. He doesn't ride well at times, but we were going to let the kid go.
Mm-hmm.
He got kind of tangled up there and then rode that whole minute and a half. So we stayed on top, and he did a nice job swinging.
145-pounder Max Benitz, second place at 145. Lost 5-0 to Bentley Schwanbeck of Marshfield, somebody that he hadn't seen yet.
Yeah, you know, I thought it was going to be worse than that, the way that first period started. He got himself, you know, kind of hung up in that
right.
bar and a wrist and battled not to get turned. And then, you know, he just has a hard time generating his own offense.
Right.
We tried turning him in that third, and I thought we were going to toss him on his back there right at the end. It was close.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it was we were going to catch four, or we were going to end up. We must be the people.
I don't know.
Working.
We must be. I don't know. We're not we're on TV right now, so. We must look important, I guess.
I
don't
so.
Know.
It must be you, not me.
Yeah, I don't know.
So
probably,
anyway,
probably Joyce.
Yeah, maybe. But he, you know, Max wrestled well to get into the finals there. You know,
mm-hmm.
it was a good match in the semis where he caught that pin. And,
right.
You know, so obviously we wanted to win that match, and it was a match that was winnable, but just came up a tad short.
Cody Sawyer at 152, finishing in second place. Maybe not his best match against Tanner Pettit. Needed to turn the wick up a little bit at the end and just couldn't find that.
Yeah, you know, Pettit's
guys, if
decent,
attention,
but he did not wrestle well. I didn't think all day offensively. I thought his defense was pretty good, but his offense not so good.
160-pounder. Brock, your son finishing in second place to another top-ranked guy in the state. Cheryl got caught up in that roll and got put on his back.
Yeah, well, he rolled through it. He was we were coming out. That's a counter to the crab ride, and he got that arm hung up in there. Stayed with the counter to that reversal. He went, dropped on that ankle too quick and stayed there. And then usually we would have come out of that on our feet. Would have been, you know, we're back still to a 4-3 match. We're right back in it, and we got hung up. And it was tight when he went under. It was nasty. We were in big trouble.
Dylan Hall at 170, finishing in third place. Got a pin coming from behind. He was in a deep hole, 7-1. Come up with a pin over Kyle Krasina of Marshfield.
Yeah, you know, we made that flip, and we're not sure where we're going next week yet. We're just trying some things out, and probably would have both guys in the finals at 60 and 70. And Dill has been kind of sick and been, you know, hurt for a while, and don't know that he wrestled great today.
Yeah.
But he finds a way to pin guys. You know, he's always dangerous in that last match. Like you said, you know, he got behind, but he's our one guy on our team that no matter what the score is, he's always got a fighter's chance.
Right. So. 182-pounder Nathan Fuller, conference champion, a 5-2 win over Sam Stroik, turned up the wick against Cody Cornier of Wausau East, 13-4.
Yeah, you know, I didn't think we wrestled real great in the finals.
Right.
I thought there was a lot of points we could have scored. But again, sometimes you get in those matches and you shut your offense down a little bit. But he needs to have a more varied attack. If he can't get, you know, that shot to go, he struggles.
Right.
He's got to start getting some more single action. And hopefully we got 3 weeks till the state tournament that we make some adjustments.
195-pounder Jake Tim ended up getting caught by Nate Engel. Nate Engel much bigger, finishing in second place. But Jake's a fun guy to watch. He wrestles hard. He lays it out there each time. And he's going to win more than he's going to lose.
Yeah, you know, we're just kind of stuck. We got a bunch of guys all weigh about the same.
170.
So, you know, so we're so small when we get to the best guys that, you know, just size-wise
right.
we can't compete. But I thought, you know, he wrestled good in that semi-match. Mm-hmm. And then he was wrestling all right. We just size-wise just got beat on size.
So. Right. Jared Mata finishing in fourth place at 220 pounds. Got pinned twice and got a pin. So
yeah, and I actually thought he wrestled really well because he was in big trouble with Kleinschmidt early in there. He would have got pinned early. He came off his back and he was trying to score. He was too small on the full size 220s.
Right.
We can beat the 200-pound 220s. We're struggling with the better
240-pound 220s.
Yeah, they're bigger, you know. so we struggle there again size wise too.
Jack Verwink, talk about size difference there. Jack Verwink in the first two matches had some full pull heavyweights, beat them 7-3 and 5-2. First year wrestler, conference champion at 285.
Yeah, you know, he did a nice job. He doesn't do a lot of different things, but that's probably what you should do when you're just new to wrestling is find a few things that you can do well and then stick with them. He did well with that, and it was fun to see him win a title.
Yes,
you know?
It was.
So. He works hard out there and does what he does and does it well and believes in himself in some spots and found a way to be a conference champ. So.
Right. Next up, the Red Raiders Valley Conference side of things is done. Tournament trail is here.
Mm-hmm.
We go to Hortonville for the regional,
mm-hmm.
and that's going to be a handful. Hortonville's got a full lineup, and the Red Raiders are going to be down one or two weight classes,
mm-hmm.
so that's a big hill to climb.
Yeah, I'm not sure what we're going to do with our lineup. Being real honest, we have to decide if we think we got a shot to win that tournament to move on to team sectionals. Because to do that, we probably are going to have some guys like we did today in the wrong weight classes.
Right.
Problem with that is if they're in the wrong weight classes at the sectional and we don't get out now, you know, if we get beaten at regional and then don't get guys to the state tournament, then all of a sudden we... sitting there with not a whole lot to shoot for at the end. So we got to kind of figure that all out. So
a lot of game planning, a lot of thinking and planning this week. So
yeah, you know, we're just a couple guys short. It's just you've seen it all year. You know, our dual meets are always just a dogfight every
and a
single
chess
one.
Match.
And you know, we're it's like we're always kind of halfway, you know, behind the eight ball, so to speak, trying to find a way to win. And the problem with when you're gambling all the time. Is eventually a gamble wrong.
It'll catch up.
You know, and my concern is that we've gambled quite a bit with this lineup that, you know, we got to really sit down and decide what we want to do. I mean, obviously our goal is to be at team state. you know, when you're winning duels like we're winning and it's a dual meet, you know,
right.
tournament, we're not really a great dual meet team this year. And so that's kind of where we're at. Hortonville is. They're actually a really good dual meet team. They've been within five of Kaukauna. They had Kaukauna down all last week at Pulaski. They're wrestling Kaukauna right now today. They were down by a few points not too long ago. So, again, we'll see. Next Saturday, we'll bring it. You know, whoever we put out there and wherever they're at, we're gonna win a lot of matches next week. And whether we're wrestling Tuesday or not, we'll find out. Yeah, we'll find out. That's been a long time since we haven't wrestled in a team sectional. So,
Coach, thanks for stopping by. We're going to celebrate today's conference title for today, and then we'll get back to work this next week. Thanks for stopping by.
Thank you. Appreciate it. Yep.
That'll be it for our broadcast today from the Valley Conference Wrestling Tournament. We'll bring you more of the regionals when we return on River City's Community Access.